Hello, everybody. This is Napa Fan here, and this is the second practice session for the Indianapolis 250. A half an hour practice session here today at the Indianapolis Motor Speed. What's going on with that incept display thing? What's the matter with that? I don't understand that. But anyways, we are here, and all 33 starters for the race. What is this? This is stupid. Maybe I should read it. Okay, there we go. I think we're good. But anyways, all 33 starters for this race are practicing now, and that includes the eight drivers who will be making their one and only start in the Haas IndyCar Series this year in this race. Now we also got the 25 full-time cars racing as well. You can see a lot of these guys coming off the pit road here. Let's go ahead and get right to it. Let's actually get to the right camera angle first. And then see who is first on the racetrack. It looks like it is our Indianapolis Grand Prix winner, Josh Crash, in the number two. So he currently sits atop the point standings coming into the Indianapolis 250. But here he is in the number two machine. First guy on track for this practice session. It's a cloudy day here today, but that's okay. Could be cloudy. Hopefully I got the right names on these. Yep, I do. Aiden Shepard, one of the Indy 250 only cars. I'm going to keep the name bar and the replay controls up here for now. But one of the Indy 250 only drivers there. Driving the number 68. Making his first ever, actually his first ever Napa Fan start will be the Freedom 40. He's one of the very few drivers, actually, who will be making a start in the Freedom 50, I should say. Not the Freedom 40. It was the Freedom 40 last year, but it's the Freedom 50 this year. But he's one of the few drivers who will be making a start in the Freedom 50 and the Indianapolis 250. Anyways, fastest guy on track right now, Ryan Madden, in the number 28, has just posted the fastest time. But that quickly changes as Noah Cars, in a Indy 250 only ride, the number 39 goes to the top of the board. We'll try to find him here. But now it's Nicholas Amadio who's fastest, and it looks like the 21 of Devin Cook is fastest now. And it is changing very frequently here, but there's your fastest driver. It is Devin Cook in the number 21 with a 40.643. Davey Johnson was fastest in practice number one on Saturday with the full-time drivers only. This is an extended practice session, half an hour long. It gives the Indy 250 only drivers a chance to get used to their cars, and it also gives more practice time to the full-time drivers. Here's the number 41 of Jesse Turner. Kind of hated that he missed a full-time ride, but it's good to have him here racing in the Indianapolis 250. He's driving the number 41 this year, and of course all the cars are equal. Whether you're a part-time or full-time car. So, interesting thing there. Josh Crash, he has been really looking strong here lately. He is now top of the board here in practice with a 40.499. Nice fast lap there for the number two. Nicholas Gratton, James Richardson side-by-side there. Another Indy 250 only driver, John Andrews, in the number eight. You see him here. You got Matt Deal in the number 20 right behind him. And Kyle Martins, another Indy 250 only driver, of course. This is the number 19, and I did say that I would retire this car because of the unfortunate passing of Justin Wilson last year, and this was his car that he drove in 2014. But I decided to add it as an Indy 250 only car, and Kyle Martins gets the special honor of driving it for this year's Indianapolis 250. Got Chris Dodd there, but our defending champion of the series. Oh, looks like Josh Crash might have had a problem there. Not entirely sure what would have happened to him there. But anyways, fastest guy on the charts right now, if I can find him, is the number 83 of Tyler Selzman, the defending champion of the Haas IndyCar Series with a 40.447. It is the 68 of Aiden Shepard, who is second on the charts. Josh Crash is third. Cameron Garlington, and the number 5... I'm not entirely sure who drives the number 5. I'm pretty sure the number 5 is a Indy 250 only car. Anyways, here's another Indy 250 only car. We got the number 6 of Julian Quintero. And he's driving the number 6 for the Indianapolis 250. It's Aaron Walpole. It's been a while since he's raced here on Napa Fan, but it's good to have him back. He is unfortunately in an Indy 250 only car, but still he's racing here. And he's 5th on the charts here in practice number 2. Of course, there will only be two practice sessions, And, of course, the first one that we had on Saturday and this one. So this is the only time these guys will practice. Tomorrow we will qualify. And qualifying is going to look exactly like this. We're going to be in a group. And there's going to be drafting and all that. I know that's not how they do it in real IndyCar, but it's the easiest way to do qualifying and actually show it to you guys. Anyways, we've got a nice line of cars here. Expect some fast speeds from these cars. They are led by Stuart Gratton. You got Josh Marzak, Cameron Garlington, and Nicholas Samedio. I think this 15 might get a good lap here, but we're just going to have to see it. 25 of Hergel Arvin Alonso has gone to second. Marty Johnson the third. Julian Quintero is now fourth on the charts. And Aiden Shepherd, well, it just changed again. And again, man, they keep on changing here. Julian Quintero goes to second. Tyler Selzman still stays up front in the 83. Cameron Garlington is now third. Hergel Arvin Alonso is now fourth. And Marty Johnson is fifth. Josh Morzak is sixth. Aiden Shepherd, Josh Crash, Stuart Gratton, and Aaron Walpole, the top 10 in practice number two. We still got a long ways to go here in the second practice. Oh, somebody went around. I see smoke. Oh no, big crash in turn four. Tyler Selzman involved. That looks to be Aiden Shepherd there involved. We got one car driving without a wheel. That's Nicholas Gratton. I saw Josh Marzak get involved. And it looks like we've had our first casualty of practice here. Oh, that's a tough one there. Let's go ahead and review it. And I think it's these guys here going three wide. It might be Marzak and Stuart Gratton getting involved here. Of course, we don't have any cautions. There are no cautions turned on. It's Garlington that spins Marzak off the racetrack. Oh, boy. Garlington also getting involved, and that was not good at all for Marzak. He flew in the air in the number 15. And Garlington is... When they get three wide coming out of the corner, that's not good. And the thing about this racetrack, when they crash in that point, they come back up the racetrack. Garrett Pick, oh man, Julian Quintero took a hard hit. Look at that, 77. Looks to be like Aaron Walpole avoided it. And so did the 25 of Hergel Arvin Alonso. But we got Aiden Shepherd. He comes into this thing kind of hard. And it does appear that he is going to avoid it, but he runs into Tyler Selzman. Ah, man. And this is something that we might see early on in the Indianapolis 250. You see Nicholas Gratton loses a wheel in the number 16. As he hit Cameron Garlington, you got James Richardson sideways on the racetrack. All these guys are sideways on the racetrack, and we have no cautions. The game doesn't have cautions for practice sessions. So because of that, these guys are coming in full speed into this crash. And we're going to go ahead and replay this in real time and then get back to the practice session. But really, really hard hit for Marzak, making his what will be second ever start. I mean, Garlington really got the worst of this one as Selzman came in and Quintero came in. And they just pile up. You see Aiden Shepherd, I should say, get involved there. And Nicholas Gratton driving with three wheels. That's kind of unique right there. Anyways, the good thing is these guys will probably get new cars and still practice here some more. Still got 23 minutes left. And we'll get back to practice here. Hold on just a minute. Okay, so we are back, and I paused the actual game. I paused it right next to I hit the pause button next to the acceleration button, so, because it didn't actually keep on going through it, and when it was done, it went right to qualifying, so we're going to be able to keep on going here till the end of this one. Anyways, Selzman is the fastest, but he does have a torn-up race car now, and I do know that Josh Crash also got torn up in the 2. But here he is back out on the racetrack. Well, I mean, I don't know if he got torn up or not, but he had a problem. But he's back out on the racetrack, looking to get some fast times here. And that's a good thing. He can easily get another car and come right back out. But anyways, the fastest drivers were involved in that crash. The top three were all involved majorly in that crash. Tyler Selzman, Julian Quintero, and Cameron Garlington, 68. He's not back out on the racetrack already, is he? And he was involved in that crash. It does appear that the 68 might have moved down. Davey Johnson, who was fastest in practice number one, he's currently running in eighth place right behind Matt Dahlia right now. And I love those sounds. I mean, I can't hear them right now, but I know you guys can. And they're great sounds. They really are. But anyways, hopefully that's the only incident we have today. Of course, we're going to be double wide coming off of the pit road. A couple guys, of course, Marzak, he took that really wild flip there, and just a couple of minutes later, he's back out on the racetrack. That's pretty cool right there. Really fearless. Get right back out there. Anyways, James Richardson in the 22 also coming back out onto the racetrack. Here's Tyler Selzman, who's fastest on the charts right now. Of course, he's the defending champion of the series. And speaking of defending champions, let's see where Christian Master is, the defending champion of this race. Driving the number 67, is 32nd on the charts. Haven't found him yet in this session. See if I can find him. Know he's somewhere. Gotta be somewhere. Where could he be? No, that's Aiden Shepard. 68 and 67 looks similar. We'll try to find him here. Master, there he is. And it looks to be like Christian Master might be coming back out on the racetrack to practice a little more here. And I think that is what he is doing. Anyways, got some good packs racing here. And we got ourselves the 83 here. Wait, no, that's the 5. What am I saying? We got the 5 here of Aaron Walpole. He's 7th on the board right now. We got Garrett Pick. We'll see where he is currently on the chart. He is 27th, so kind of slow for the 11. Eric Jalarvin Alonso in the number 25. How about Josh Marzak in the 15? As I said, he was fearless. He was really fearless on that lap. Second quickest. And he's in this pack. He's behind this pack drafting with everybody. So expect some fast time from these guys. Now, when we are racing, we're going to see faster speeds than we see here in practice, which is kind of interesting. And we've got Davey Johnson, who was fastest in practice number one on Saturday. You got Josh Marzak, who's just gone the second on the board. You got this pack led by Matt Dalio. You know he's good. Now Nathan Stapleton and the Aero Electric Pro Series champion, James Richardson. Nathan Stapleton, I forgot, he actually is a champion. He won the Season 2 Turkey Hill Series Championship, so congratulations to him on that. That was a while ago, but he's still a champion on this channel, and he definitely knows how to get it done. And this pack here, I don't think any of them improved their times that time by, but they're looking good. Single file, that's good for Marzak, especially because he's a little ways behind Davey Johnson, and he'll be able to close up to him here, or really, he's a little higher, so he might not necessarily get the draft on him. Anyways, Tyler Selzman is still the fastest car out there on the racetrack with a 40.323 as his fastest lap. And let's see if I can change the lap info. I guess we can. I thought there might be a way to get the speeds, but no. But anyways, Davey Johnson picks up right where he left off. He's now top of the board here in practice 2 once again. 40.308 in this pack. That is extremely fast for the number 33. And this is a 2.5 mile racetrack. You're going 2.5 miles in 40 seconds. That's insane. You see the miles per hour up there. And down the straightaways especially, they're going 220-something. That's extreme. And Davey Johnson now fastest on the chart. So it's Davey Johnson, Tyler Selzman, Josh Marzak, Julian Quintero, and Cameron Garlington, the top 5 fastest speeds so far in this race. And this is looking crazy. They're all over the place. Got Davey Johnson. These guys are like testing out for what the race is going to be like, because we're going to have a lot of double wide in the race. And you definitely want to avoid going 3 wide, because it's 3 wide when we get the crashes, especially coming out of turn number 3. So you got to be careful not to go 3 wide. But it's good to have some practice going double wide, trying to move your way through the pack. And this is what these guys are doing right now. They're getting that practice for the big race, because if you don't know how to pass in a pack like this, you're not going to be doing good. And oh no, again, another crash! James Richardson upside down in the fence on top of Davey Johnson. Matt Dalio coming in there. Hopefully nobody else gets involved, but it was Marzak again getting involved, and unfortunately he still has a little bit to learn. Somehow the rookies always end up getting involved in crashes. Man, Marzak has had some day already. I mean, he's had cars above him, cars on top of him. He's been upside down. He's been on top of a car. And all that, he's still third quickest. But still, massive crash there. Of course, Richardson, look at that! Richardson, you saw how much he was flying through the air? He drives by Marzak, and it doesn't look like he has too much damage to his race car. He's in gear four, where he's gonna come in, get a new car, but still. I'm not gonna review that because it's, I don't want to pause the practice, but you guys saw it as it happened live, and it's a tough break for Marzak again. But still, this is practice. You got as many cars as you want to. This is a video game, so it's not like these cars really cost anything. So that's good good news for that 15 team. But still, can this guy catch a break? Seriously, this is insane. Anyways, fastest is still Davey Johnson, and I think he's already gotten a new car and is coming back out onto the racetrack. So he was involved. Davey Johnson was involved in that crash. You see the tire marks on the racetrack there. Not entirely sure who else was involved. I think Delio might have gotten a piece of it. It was that five-car pack. And what ended up happening, somebody, I forget who did it, but somebody went three wide to the inside of Marzak and Richardson. And it was Richardson that got into Marzak, and they went up into the wall. And Richardson, you saw him flying through the air. That was pretty crazy. But anyways, that's the kind of danger this race poses, and it's definitely one of the hardest races to win. I mean, this is very, very tough. The NRLA big one's different because you're driving stock cars over there. These things are going much faster. We're on a flatter racetrack, and you gotta have grip through the corner, and these things are on the verge of just spinning out, and when you go three wide, and when you crash here especially, it is extremely violent. But fortunately, this is just a video game. I do not treat it like, you know, injuries happen or anything like that. So if you crash, you crash. Just get right back out there like Marzak has twice already. Of course, he's still on the pit road waiting to get a new car. Might want to wait a little bit more before he gets back out there. He's already been involved in two crashes. Probably doesn't want to get involved in another one. Matt Delio, I think he was partly involved in that as well. Probably got some damage, and that's why he's on the pit road. Now, these cars, they don't really show damage that well, unfortunately. Of course, it takes a lot. It takes a really hard hit for damage to work on these cars. And we're going to end up with a pretty big pack here. And this is going to be interesting. We're coming up on Cameron Gaju here. And an unfortunate day in the Grand Prix of Indianapolis. He started on the pole for that race. And had trouble on the pit road, unfortunately. We got Jesse Turner here in the 40. Whoa! Walpole! Man, he really went fast getting that pit road. I thought something happened to him. Anyways, got this pack here, led by Nicholas Grattan in the 16. We got Kyle Martins, an Indy 250 only driver, in the 19. Chris Dodd is here. We got Jesse Turner, another Indy 250 only driver. Davey Johnson and Cameron Gaju. Cameron Gaju is a full-time driver this season. Matt Dalio's coming back onto the racetrack, and that three-car pack went around him there, and that was close. Don't want to crash again. We've already had two major crashes in this race, or in this practice session already. Don't want that to happen again. Anyways, the 17 of Noah Clifton has just moved his way to third quickest in the number 17. I'm not sure how long he's been there. Oh, you gotta watch out for these guys here. And they're going double wide like this. That's when it gets really, really crazy. You got Jesse Turner, Cameron Gaju, Matt Dalio, Davey Johnson. Johnson's the fastest. And we're gonna end up with a pretty big pack here. Got Matt, or no, that's not Matt Dalio. That is Kyle Martins. Matt Dalio's back in here. He's in this pack. Got Chris Dodd, Nicholas Grattan here, Jill Arvin Alonso. And they're all led by Kyle Martins right now in the number 19. These guys, they're going 220 plus miles per hour, door-to-door, basically. If these things had doors. They don't have doors, though. But they are wheel-to-wheel in these cars. Oh, so close, going oh, so fast. It's insane out here, and these guys better be careful, because we do not want to end up with another crash in this practice session. We've already had two big ones already. We don't want that to happen again. And he's got another four-car pack in front of these guys, with Noah Clifton, who is now fourth on the charts because Jesse Turner in the 41 has moved his way up to second on the grid. We might see some more fast times from this pack. This pack is really, really big. We got Davey Johnson in it as well. We'll see if any of these times change. They might. we'll see. Doesn't look like any of them did. But Jesse Turner is second on the charts. Actually, they did change. Davey Johnson with a 40.230. Wow, that is extremely fast in that number 33. And this pack's going to get big. Oh, no! Marnie Johnson just LePaged the field right into Jesse Turner. Nicholas Grattan also involved. Oh, my goodness. My goodness gracious. That 18 almost arc-braked into all those guys there. I tell you, Marty Johnson's not the kind of driver that would do something like that, but hey, of course, it's just a video game, you know. The computer's controlling it, but still. Pretty good driver there, making a pretty bad mistake. Of course, that wasn't as big as it could have been, but Jesse Turner and Nicholas Grattan getting involved there with the 12 of Marty Johnson. Of course, we saw it live, and since we saw it live, we're not going to replay it. Anyways, Davey Johnson still fastest, and he had just beat his fastest time of the day. Let's see where he is on the racetrack. Jesse Turner is still out there. Turner did not come in the pit row, and it looks like he's okay. It might have been Nicholas Grattan who Marty Johnson ran into, but it looks like Jesse Turner, he's running pretty good here in this number 41. And you can see how many laps they've run. They've run quite a few laps already. 24 laps for Jesse Turner. And that's pretty good. I mean, the race is 100 laps long, and it's good to get a good amount of practice in here. Still have 10 minutes left in this session. And it is Davey Johnson leading the field with the fastest time. Jesse Turner is second. Tyler Salzman, Noah Clifton, and how about Matt Dalio? Dalio's moved his way up to fifth. Then it's the 7 of Cameron Gaudu, the 15 of Josh Marzak, the number 6 of Julian Quintero, Cameron Garlington, and Josh Crash, the top 10. Got Noah Carr here in the 39. Haven't really talked about him too much today. Haven't really talked about Stapleton either. Elijah Gordon, you know, there's 33 guys starting this race. How about the two Ganassi cars going side by side, Nicholas Amedeo and Audra Baranowskis, and they look identical. They really do look identical, but the 9 has a white wing on the side there, while the 10 has a red wing on the side, so. And of course, one says 9, the other says 10, so there is a difference. But they look very similar, and especially when they're running right next to each other, it's kind of hard to tell the difference. But it is Sam Adio out front of Audra Baranowskis. Tyler Salzman's back out on the racetrack. He's done 26 laps so far today. He is third on the charts with a 40.323. Wolfgang Stone, another. I don't think we've talked about Wolfgang Stone at all. Driving the number 91. He is an Indy 250 only driver. I think we haven't talked about him because he hasn't been in a pack and does look like not doing too bad. 21st out of 33 drivers. That's pretty good. But a 40.455. That's a pretty fast lap. And the number 7 of Cameron Gaudu has just moved his way up to second, while Matt Dalio has moved his way up to third. Where is Gaudu? We'll see if he can find him here. Yep, this 3-car pack, and it's got Davey Johnson as well. And these are the 3 fastest cars in practice so far. Davey Johnson, Cameron Gaudu, and Matt Dalio. But it is still the number 33 who just got into the outside wall who's fastest. And Davey Johnson looking to win both practice sessions. That means that number 33 is extra solid here for the Indianapolis 250. And we'll see what he can do in qualifying tomorrow. But it's looking good for Davey Johnson to get the pole position. But we're just going to have to see. I mean, this is exactly how qualifying is going to be. We're going to have eliminations. We're going to have 3 rounds. All 33 drivers will race qualify in a 15-minute session. Then I don't know how many are going to advance on. I think maybe 18. And they haven't really determined how many will advance on from there. But we might have 18 advance on for a 10-minute session. And then the top 9, the fastest 9, go for the fast 9 shootout, 5 minutes long. And whoever's fastest of those 9 grabs the pole position for the Indianapolis 250. And we've got Kyle Martins here. Matt Tuck in the 27. Really haven't talked about him much today. Been up there, and Tuck is currently 21st on the charts. We got these three cars here, and these are all pretty good drivers. Cameron Gaju, Matt Dallio, and Davey Johnson. And they've definitely showed it with their speeds here today. Top three fastest in practice number two for the Indianapolis 250. Got Stuart Bratton leading Aaron Walpole. Ryan Searless, haven't talked about him that much. See where Searless is. He is 31st. Not looking too good for the 26 right now. Number 10, Avadra Baranowskis, is also slow, but the slowest guy out there is Elijah Gordon in the number 34. Where is he? No, he's got to be somewhere. There he is. He's coming back out to run a few more laps before the session ends. But Elijah Gordon, the slowest driver out there right now. Not too good for that 34 at all. And we got Josh Marzak and Julian Quintero coming back out to the racetrack. Got Jesse Turner about three... Or sorry, Josh Marzak's a full-time driver. What am I saying? Got two part-time drivers here. Julian Quintero and Jesse Turner. They're side-by-side. Ryan Madden. Got Noah Kahrs here in the 39. See where Noah Kahrs is here. Kahrs is 28th, looking pretty slow, unfortunately, for him. Now, Cameron Garlington, he's running 9th right now, pretty good for him. Nathan Stapleton in the 98 is 16th on the board. You got Nicholas Samadio here in the 9. He is currently running in 31st. The Ganassi guys are kind of slow here today. You got Matt Deal in the 20, running 27th. Wolfgang Stone is 23rd. John Anders in the 8, running 19th. James Richardson, he's 11th on the charts. Audra Baranowskis is 32nd. Josh Crash is currently 10th. Matt Tucker, 27th, is currently, where is he? 27th, 15th. Kyle Martins in the 19 is currently running in 18th. Matt Dallio is 3rd fastest. Davey Johnson is the fastest driver on the in the field right now. Cameron Gaju is 2nd fastest. You got Tyler Seldon 5th fastest. Aaron Walpole, he was up there earlier, so falling back to 17th. Got Stuart Bratton in the 18. He is currently running in 29th. Ryan Searless, he's moved his way up to 24th. Jill Arvin Alonso is currently running 13th fastest. Noah Clifton is 6th fastest. Elijah Gordon, I think we've cycled through most of the drivers here. He's still last. Devin Cook here is 22nd. Julian Quintero, we might have already gone through these guys. I don't know. I don't think we have. Quintero is 8th. Marzak is 7th. Turner is 4th. Ryan Madden in the 28. He is currently running in, where is he? 30th. Not too good for the 28. Cameron Garlington is 9th, and I think we've cycled through most of these guys. Christian Master, the defending winner of this race, the Indianapolis 250. Of course, it was the Indianapolis 200 last year. He's currently 26th, but he's avoided much of the drama here today, which is a good thing for him. And we know he can get it done. He was running good in the first Indianapolis 200 as well, the first one I did when it was a special event that first time. That was a year ago. And he was running well, but he ended up getting involved in the crash late in the going, and that's Elijah Gordon, and that might explain why he hasn't been too good today. A blown engine on the 34 with only 3 minutes remaining. It's a tough break for him, and doesn't look like that 34 team has much figured out yet. Not looking too good for Elijah Gordon, but you never know. They might get it together for qualifying. We're just going to have to see. And anyways, the fastest driver is still Davey Johnson in number 33. He was fastest on Saturday, looking to be fastest here today. And Davey Johnson looks like the car to beat here in the Indianapolis 250. But we're just going to have to find out in these next few days if he will, in fact, be the driver to beat. Because these are just practice sessions. They don't really mean much. He's got Gaju still behind him. Cameron Gaju has run 37 laps. See if anybody else has run that much. Gaju has run a lot. Oh, we got a 38 here by Noah Kahrs. Noah Kahrs has been running a lot of laps here. 38 laps for him. And then we go back to Gaju at 37. So Noah Kahrs has been out there longer than anybody else. He has run 39 laps, which is the number that he is driving for the Indianapolis 250. But he's looking to get accustomed to this kind of car. And any 250 only driver driving that number 39 in the Indianapolis 250 on Saturday. And we're closing down the final minute of practice number two here for the Indianapolis 250. And it does appear that Davey Johnson's going to be able to win it. Some other guys looking to improve here, trying to figure things out in this final minute before they get the qualifying tomorrow. Ryan Searless. He's figured some things out, but still not the best. Still, he's improved. I mean, he's 14th now, doing a good job in that 26. And the 18, we got a new guy in the top five. Stuart Grattan has just moved his way up to fourth on the charts. See if I can find him here. Number 18 of a late run there. A late push there to get himself in the top five. He is fourth fastest on the charts. Stuart Grattan with a 40.315. Look at how close some of those times are. They're all in the 42nd bracket, but the top 10 are separated by about 15 tenths of a second. That's 15 tenths. That's just stupid. 15 one hundredths of a second, I should say. Not 15 tenths, because if you have 15 tenths, that's 1.5, which, you know what I mean. Anyways, the clock has run out, but it does appear we're going to get a little extra time here, maybe. But the clock is not coming back on. So it does appear that number 33, we'll get to him here, Davey Johnson. If I can find him, there he is. Looks like he's going to win practice number two. And that is two in a row here. This 33 is looking really strong. We're just going to have to see. He beat everybody else here. If you notice the difference, you know, between Gaju, Dalio, Stuart Grattan, and Jesse Turner, they're all kind of close, but Davey Johnson is 7/100 faster than everybody else. And I know that doesn't seem like much, but if you compare the difference between everybody behind him and all the differences they have, he beat the number 7 of Cameron Gaju by the same distance as Cameron Gaju beat Cameron Garlington. And Gaju and Garlington, they are 8 positions away from each other. Davey Johnson and Cameron Gaju are only 1 position away from each other. But anyways, there it is. It's done. Davey Johnson on the pole position. Not on the pole driver position, I should say. But he has won practice number two. And he is looking very, very strong in that number 33. It was Davey Johnson, Cameron Gaju, Matt Dalio, Stuart Grattan, Jesse Turner, Tyler Selsman, Noah Clifton, Josh Marzak, Julian Quintero, and Cameron Garlington. The top 10 fastest in practice two. Take a look at the rest of the results right here. Some guys that need to get it together for qualifying. Christian Master, the defending Indianapolis 250 winner, was 28th fastest. Not looking too good for that 67. We got Matt Deal, Ryan Madden, Nicholas Amadio, Audra Baranowskis, and Elijah Gordon, all with kind of slow times there. Noah Cars, Chris Dodd, Wolfgang Stone, Devin Cook, Nicholas Grattan. I mean, they're all kind of around that area where they need good lap times. But Ryan Madden, Nicholas Samadio, Audra Baranowskis, and Elijah Gordon, especially the Ganassi guys, the 9 and the 10 there, they definitely need to get it together. However, the other Ganassi car, or one of the other Ganassi cars, I should say, Tyler Selsman, running 6th, so looking pretty good there for the 83 team. But anyways, thank you guys very much for watching. Congratulations to Davey Johnson for winning the second practice of Indianapolis 250 week, and we'll see how well he does tomorrow for Indianapolis 250 qualifying. But anyways, thank you guys very much for watching, and I will see you guys later.